Oh.
Oh.
You should do it. You should do it.
We'll talk Baker Mayfield's new coach in a second, but first, Lonzo Ball with the nice little touch pass to JaVale McGee.
Lakers played some good ball yesterday. Much needed win.
A big win. Most notably, Kuzma, after his worst game of the year, had the best game of his career. But that is what Lonzo, for all his struggles, what he still does well is see the court. Still a very good passer.
Very good passer. Very unselfish.
Yeah, hasn't developed the way you
hoped. Anthony Davis gets not one, but two blocks on this. First on Jordan Clarkson, and then recovers.
This is the reason why I let him wear the unibrow. When you can do stuff like this, you can allow a guy to, you know, have a hair across his face. Like, you get not even saying that.
I got no problem with the unibrow. I got a huge problem with the Pelicans biting the style of the old school Nuggets jerseys. What, are we all of a sudden going to have an NFL team wearing the star on their helmet? These are Nuggets jerseys ripoffs, Pelicans.
Well, I don't think when you've ever won either one of them, you're ripping someone's style.
Ooh, more from Davis. Watch him get creative with the handles here, guys.
No, it just seems like this year, man, he's doing more things off the dribble. Last couple of years working on his three-pointer. He's got the defenses run at him. Now he's going to the hole.
You made this point earlier. I think it's a great point that maybe Anthony Davis always had these dribble moves, but people weren't respecting his outside shot, so he didn't have the reason to show it or the ability
to
show it.
Well, remember, he hit the big growth spurt. He was a point guard. He hit that huge growth spurt that made him an interior player.
Going to Kentucky,
Moving on back to football now, the Cleveland Browns, who started the season with Hugh Jackson as their head coach and ended the season with Greg Williams as their head coach, will go into the offseason with yet another as their head coach. The Browns hired Freddie Kitchens, their offensive coordinator, to be the guy in Cleveland. Kitchens, who began the season as the Browns' running backs coach, created a great relationship with Baker Mayfield. All right, Steve, what'd you make of this hire for the Browns and for Baker Mayfield?
I thought it was a good hire for the Browns. Now, the Browns, they did an extensive search, and what they were looking for as far as moving forward. To me, too, they didn't make a long-term commitment. Most of these coaches are going to get four years, but when you have someone who doesn't have the experience, young guy like this, you're not committed to something that is going to hamstring the franchise. I believe he has a connection with Baker Mayfield that I believe is very, very important. And in doing a game with the Browns late in the season where they upset Carolina, a game Carolina had to win to try to get in, I could see in communicating with the players and going to practice and in sitting down with Freddie Kitchens and interviewing him extensively that he was a guy that could put together a game plan. I was shocked by the amount of football that he knew as a running back coach, how much he knew about being the quarterback, because he's a former quarterback, University of Alabama, how much he understood about the passing game, how much he understood about protections, and he had command of that side of the ball. And people right now, they think that, man, I got to have an offensive coach, I got to have a defensive coach. The old style in the NFL was for one guy to run one part of the ball and have someone else run it. So in Cleveland, they have that with Freddie Kitchens, and he has the respect of that locker room, and more importantly, he has that quarterback, the number one pick in the draft, ascending the way you want the first pick in the draft going as far as his career, Nick.
Here is my primary concern, other than the fact that 9 weeks ago he was a running backs coach and now he's the head coach, aside from the lack of head coaching experience, and that when Hugh Jackson and Todd Haley got fired, we talked about how, my God, all that knowledge is going out the building and they're left with Freddie Kitchens, and now he's the head coach. My concern aside from that is this. We look at Baker Mayfield's season as before Freddie Kitchens took over and after. What if it was before he stopped being shackled by Hugh and Todd and whatever the hell was going on between them and after? What if Baker was waiting to be this guy and the only reason he wasn't, it was less about getting with Freddie Kitchens and more about getting away from the toxicity of the Hugh Todd power struggle. It felt to me like, and I really like Todd Haley personally, it felt to me like he was, while offensive coordinating, kind of trying to angle behind the scenes, which is one of the reasons reportedly they didn't keep him on after they got rid of Hugh Jackson. So that's my concern. How much of Baker's great second half was because Baker's great? And how much of it was Freddie Kitchens? What is encouraging, and I just read it 10 minutes ago, it was reported on Cleveland.com early this morning, the Browns organizationally are not going to make a mistake they've made in the past, which is the GM reports to the owner and the coach reports to the owner. They have decided that under this, it is the head coach reports to Dorsey, and the only person who has Haslam's ear is Dorsey, which I don't have a lot of faith in Jimmy Haslam. I have enormous faith in John Dorsey, and now that the buck stops ultimately with him, I think that's a positive feature.
It was some of the reporters that asked him, well, do you think you're ready to be the head coach? And he said, well, who the hell is ready to be the head coach of a team? You're going to learn when you get there. But he seems to have something, whether it was because Greg Williams is there or because Todd Haley and Hugh Jackson weren't there. He has some relationship with Baker Mayfield. How is he best served to help Baker grow?
Well, I think his football is very, very strong. You're not going to get hired by John Dorsey, Alonzo Highsmith, who does the pro football operations, unless your football is very, very strong. And I was there. He had command of half of that football team. He had Baker Mayfield's attention. Baker Mayfield, they talked about in the whole evaluation process, among the things that he had was a photographic memory. The Browns would not hire him if they didn't have some type of synchness. I was synced in. Freddie Kitchens let me know what the first 15 plays of the game was going to be against Carolina. And he went out and methodically took that defense apart in a time where they had to win a game. So his football, his X's and O's is respected. The command of that locker room and his delivery of messages, I thought, was consistent that got these guys' attention, because you can see the results on the field. Playing in tight games, tight situations, red zone, third down. You could see these guys performing. It's not like they got an abundance of talent there. This organization changed when Freddie Kitchen was given more control. He played quarterback. Hugh ain't never played quarterback. Todd ain't played no quarterback. So, yeah, they've been in the NFL a long, long time. But I believe as a play caller, he really made his mark on this team and with Baker Mayfield. Now,
listen, I hope this is successful because I love Baker's personality. I like the way he carries himself, and I think he's a special talent in the league. If he is successful as a head coach, not just because Baker's really good, but successful in his own right, then I think every organization needs to take a harder look at their entire coaching roster. Because if this guy is ready to be a head coach, he was an untapped resource for years and years, steps away from being head coach.
Well, we talked about Frank Wright. They missed on him. Right. End up finding gold at the bottom.
No one else.
He wasn't their first choice. What about Anthony Lynn? Another guy, Nick, you very, very, you respect. He's never been a coordinator. And guess what position he was coaching? He was coaching running backs.
Right.
I believe that running back coaches are an untapped resource in the NFL. The reason why, they know the running game. They know the pass protecting game because the running backs are involved in the pass protection. And they know the passing game because you can't be a running back now and not be be integrated in the passing game. So I believe it's an untapped resource. You don't have to be a coordinator to be able to take over and be able to run half the team. One of the greatest coaches ever, Joe Gibbs. What'd he do? Man, when they used to ask him a question at the press conference, he said, hey, you want to know about the defense? Hey, talk to Richie Pettigone.